To speak fluent English, keep these 30 words in mind. They will always be useful. Today we'll learn some words that we need to know when we learn English. By learning these, your English vocabulary will increase a lot. You should not get stuck in speaking English if you learn these words. Mind. It means the part of a person that makes it possible for him or her to think, feel emotions and understand things. Never mind. Do you mind? I don't mind. He changed his mind. Astonished. It means very surprised. We were astonished at the news. She was quite astonished at his rudeness. Treasure. It means very valuable things. He went to the island looking for treasure. Wealth. It means a large amount of money and other valuable possessions. Health is better than wealth. Without wisdom, wealth is worthless. Adventure. It means an unusual, exciting, and possibly dangerous activity, trip, or experience. Young people love adventure. I read a book of adventure stories. Roam. It means to move about or travel. Wild animals roamed across the plains. I like to roam around the fields. Growl. It means a long, low sound made by a dog. The dog growled at a little boy. My stomach is growling. Gauge. It means to look at something or someone for a long time. He gazed at me. She refused to meet my gaze. Queen. It means call of doves. The doves were queeing in the trees. The two doves are queeing under the leaves. Do you hear the queen? Mound. It means very small hill. The children are playing on the mound. It was easy to pick holes in the mound. Yawning. It means opening mouth widely. I am yawning because I feel sleepy. I felt so sleepy I couldn't stop yawning. Gale. It means a very strong wind or storm. It's blowing a gale out there. A gale was blowing from the east. Necessary. It means the basic requirements of life. I felt it was necessary, so I did it. If necessary, I can come at once. Nothing so necessary for travelers as languages. Guidance. Help and advice about how to do something or help to find the way. He did the work with his teacher's guidance. Children look to their parents for guidance. Observe. It means to watch carefully. I am just here to observe. I want to observe all the details. Mean. It means to express or represent something such as an idea, thought, or fact. I mean that. What do they mean? Signify. To be a sign of something. What do those lights signify? It is no use to signify. Fruity. It means tasting or smelling like fruit. This drink is soft and fruity. This wine has a full of fruity flavor. as you. To tell someone confidently that something is true. I assure you that is not necessary. I assure you that is not necessary. We can assure you of our full support. Patter. It means move with light steps. Are you going to hear the patter of tiny feet? Pause. It means the foot of an animal such as a cat, dog or bear. The cat was licking its paws. Cats hide their paws. All cats love fish but fear to wet their paws. Perch. It means a place where a bird sits. The bird took its perch. Peer. It means to look carefully. It will not be easy to find his peer. Gas. It means a large amount of liquid or gas that flows quickly. I had a gas of water. Located. It means to be in a particular place. The school is located near the river. The palace was located in the middle of a forest. Situated. It means in a particular position. My house is situated near the park. Immense. It means extremely large in size. The expense of living is immense. Huge. It means extremely large in size or amount. There was a huge hole in the road. Meanwhile. It means until something expected happens. I will be back soon. Meanwhile, follow on. You have to learn a lot of vocabulary to speak English. Only then you can speak English fluently. However, learn this way you will remember for a long time. And whatever vocabulary you learn, you must use them in your life when you have the opportunity. Otherwise, you will quickly forget what you learn. I hope it will help you to remember any new words.